Dans ce montage vidéo technique, on débute en Lyon avec l'équipe Roosevelt. Un des barbiers de Charême est en direct de Rotterdam et vous présente une des coupes classiques, la Pompadour. Je vous invite à garder un œil attentif sur les détails et vous verrez que l'utilisation de la pommade est tout un art.
Hey everybody, this is Rob, straight from the Holy Ashtray, Schoon Haarsnijder and Barbier in Rotterdam, and today we're going to do another haircut. We got some really positive reactions on the last one, so if you like what we're doing, please subscribe to our channel. Well, today we're going to go for the most classic of them all, the Pompadour, the 50s Pompadour, as made famous by Elvis Aaron Presley. Here we go. As always, I'm going to start with thoroughly wetting the hair. Now, there is still some old product in Jago's hair, which I actually like. I'm going to use a little bit of that old product and the stickiness of that old product to look for the haircut that's hidden in the hair. I'm going to start by dividing the hair in two, following the natural implant of the hairline. This is going to be my first section. I'm going to take out another section in the front by following the other natural hairline in the temple area, leaving that front triangle out to play with later. That's going to be our pompadour. Okay, today I'm going to work with a combination of scissor, sectioning, and clipper work. Gonna set in my first section, which is gonna be my guideline throughout the haircut. Now, remember, it's the shape and the angle of your fingers that are gonna determine the length on the side and the length on top. That means that the tip of your fingers will point to the length on top, right? So this length is gonna be this long, so we're gonna have a nice full pompadour. When you're in doubt, check your fingers, because it's basically the same shape you do with clippers. Yeah, a taper or a section is basically the same. Continue following that guideline into the nape area, and behind the ear I'm gonna follow the previous cut section in the same angle towards the nape area. Follow the natural shape of the skull while looking at the natural fall of the hair. I'm gonna leave a lot of weight on the crown area because I want his pompadour to be as square and masculine as possible. After setting in the base, cross-check yourself by taking horizontal sections
Do not remove length. Just check for excess weight. Lifting the hair for graduation. This way you stay in control throughout the haircut. I'm gonna switch the clippers. I set my clippers to zero and I'm just gonna focus on the hand that holds the comb, because the angle of the comb stays the same as the angle I would cut with my fingers. Nothing changes but my tool. I'm gonna follow that previous cut, my previous cut sections, holding my comb in the same angle as I would do with my fingers. So I'm not focusing on my clipper hand, I'm focusing on the hand that holds the comb. Removing weight and length. Set my clipper to half, open on the Babyliss FX Pro, but whether, doesn't really matter what kind of clippers you're using, set the lever to its longest. Back to close clipper. Cleaning out the nape area. Moving to the area around the ear, doing exactly the same thing. Following my previous cut baseline and guideline. Removing excess weight, but not perfecting the haircut yet. We'll get to that when the hair is dry. I'm gonna take my next section on top. Gonna use the widest point of the head to take out my next section. And within that section, I'm gonna take a section about an inch wide. I'm gonna over-direct my section to that previous cut baseline right there. I'm going to connect all the hair on top to the previous cut section. By over-directing the hair, you're keeping the weight, but the hair transitions super nice into the nape area. You can double check yourself by taking vertical sections, not taking off any length, just check for excess weight. Inch wide section in the front triangle. I'm gonna connect this front triangle in quite a heavy way, slightly disconnected. Lift the hair, take off weight. I'm gonna repeat that same process till all the hair is cut and connected to that crown area. Gonna move to that front triangle, take another section in that triangle, comb it down, taking some hair from my previous cut, hair on the side. I want to work with a lot of length for my pompadour, so I'm going to disconnect the hair in front. Start close to the face, leaving it super heavy, and then slightly lift, take out excess weight. And repeat on the full triangle. Till no hair comes off. Add a little bit of water. Check your hair cut for balance at this point. At this point, you should have a little bit of a disconnection in the temple area, but the hair should move fluently into that nape area. As you can see, my pompadour basic shape is already there. Nice fenders on the side, creating a super old school vintage look. This side is done. A lot of length fluently transferred into that short nape area. And we're gonna repeat exactly the same thing on the other side. The angle you used for cutting the hair with your scissors should direct the angle of your comb doing your clipper work. Try to forget about this hand and focus on this hand and this hand only. Look at what the hair will tell you. The angles are already there, you just have to follow them. Taking one section in the middle, taking a little bit of excess weight to accentuate the length in front. Double check by pulling all the hair to the middle. Check for excess weight. gonna add a little bit of our Rouzo tonic. It's the most old school product that we got. There is some old oil-based pomade left in his hair. I really like to reactivate and kind of clean the scalp with our tonic before I dry the hair. Not too much, just to clean the scalp, make the hair more manageable. Massage it into the scalp and it smells really good. It's got a really, really nice old school masculine fragrance. Gonna move to drying the hair. So, when the haircut is dry, you can already see what you gotta do. See, I basically roughly faded it in. Now I'm gonna take care of all the details. Starting with my outline. You don't really wanna skin fade the thing in. That is not a thing of the 40s and the 50s. So I'm going to work with a nice taper, leaving it slightly longer around the ears so my outlines really stand out. Especially when you do those longer fendered or tapered pompadours, I suggest you check your outline and refine your outline with your scissor. Because you comb the hair back, that hair actually becomes part of your outline. So refine, refine again. And look what works best for your patron's hair. Refine the fade in the nape area with your clippers both closed and open. Look for those little spots. But this is definitely where your personal taste comes in. I really like a tapered look on my client because it's actually gonna accentuate the fullness of the crown area. See, I like that really thick squareness of the pompadour. Take all the time you want and need and got to make that nape area look as tight as possible. Of course, if you want to use guards, use guards. If you want to use your scissor over comb, use your scissor over comb. If you want to use your blenders, use blenders. It really doesn't matter what you use. It's all about the client. Yeah, it's all about the final result. So I'll use a technique that you're comfortable with. Okay, I'm gonna use both blenders and my normal scissors, and I'm gonna look for bulk and weight and remove that. Diego's hair is pretty strong. Now, I use these blenders to accentuate the haircut. I am not using them to thin the hair. You gotta see the hair like Velcro, especially when you use an oil-based pomade. You want those ends of the hair to stick together. So I'm gonna follow the lines I cut when the hair was still wet, and I'm gonna use my blenders in the flow of the haircut. It might look like I'm taking away a lot of hair, but I'm not. See, I'm really just looking for weight. And then within that natural fall, while slightly lifting the hair, I'm taking out weight. So you're gonna get a beautiful blend into the hair in the back. So don't use your blenders to ram out some hair, but really stay in control throughout the haircut. Look for weight and look what the hair is telling you. Take out weight, same angle, yeah, check for heavy spots. If there's heavy spots left, just use a freehand slicing technique to blend in the length in the nape area. See? Switch to the length on top. Check for weight. One lift. Two. And switch to your length on top. Basically, what you got here is a cross check throughout the complete haircut, blending all that length into the cut. This part of the haircut is the most fun. What you see is what you get. And at this point, you're really sculpting the hair the way you want it. This is basically when you put your signature into the haircut. Check your final results. Refine outlines even more, refine bulk even more. Make sure your haircut is exactly you want it, as well as exactly as your client wants it. Yeah, during the haircut, keep looking for the flow of the cut. Yeah? What is the wave telling you? Once you're satisfied with your shape, we're gonna move to product. Okay, final check of the weight in that front triangle. See, if you twist your fingers, the hair will spread, makes it easier to look for bulk. So, Jago, shh. Blend it all together and make sure that even with the length, the hair has enough air so you can build up the height in the pompadour. Okay, it's an old school pompadour, so I'm gonna use an old school product. You can use any oil-based pomade you want. Of course, I'm gonna go for our own brand, Ruzel. I'm gonna mix a little bit of the stronger donut pink.
Hey, it's glorious.
A little bit of the pink and a little bit of the green. Now, I know a lot of barbers and hairdressers go like, grease. But you gotta understand that for some haircuts, you need grease. And this is an oil-based product. It's different than a clay or a water-based product. You really want to drown the hair into the product. You wanna drown the hair with product. And I can tell you, I've known my clients for a long time, right? All barbers know you build up a band of trust with your clients. I know how much product he uses. And the whole trick with an oil-based product is that you want the hair to be smothered with it. You really want to be able to clay the hair into the shape you want to have. Actually, an oil-based product is going to work better the longer it's in the hair. Yeah? I'm talking about days gone by, but Elvis Presley had his own unique mix of oil-based product. There were no other products than oil-based products. So make sure you use a lot. The moment it's in the hair, make sure you divide it thoroughly over the hair by combing it in all directions. You want the grease to be everywhere so you can really clay the hair into the shape you want to have. Again, it's not for everybody. You cannot have a new client that's never used grease before and then take four fingers of an oil-based product and smother the hair with it, because it is hard to wash out. We understand that. But if you got a client that knows how to use grease, I've been doing hair for 30 years, and for me, this is basically why I started doing this job. I really, really love that old school look filled up with an old school product. See, you can already see that the hair starts to become really pliable. So, here you go. This is the final result of my 50s Elvis Presley inspired pompadour. Now the thing is, a lot of people in the comments always go like, oh, but what if he's gonna do it himself? See, that is the thing. People that use grease know how to style their hair. And I tell you something more, they usually do it way and way better than me or you. Because, you know, I see him every what? Month, 2 months. He sees himself every day. So he's been practicing for the last 20 years. So, Jago, please, show us your expertise, my friend.
done.
I hate you. I hate you and your hair.
Vous vous demandez comment faire un beau fade? Vous cherchez toujours la bonne manière de faire un afro? L'équipe Wall a tous les outils pour vous permettre d'être les maîtres dans la matière. Dans ce segment, vous avez deux vidéos qui vous montrent l'art d'utiliser les outils Wall qui faciliteront votre travail.
Just on the beat. Banks on the beat. Banks on the beat.
Damn, Missy Mari got beat. Missy Mari got beat. I'm Mizzy Mari got beats. Mizzy Mari got beats.
Avouez que vous avez plein d'idées qui tournent dans votre tête. Prenez le temps de noter vos idées. Vous avez même l'opportunité de revoir les vidéos.